March 13th, 2018, I suffered a paralysis of my left side of my face. That's why you see the mouth going down. My eye does not blink, and so I've got a real dry eye, and I'm hopefully going to be able to fix that up because it affects my vision just a little bit. I will update this intro to my videos when things start improving, and they will, I'm sure. At least it wasn't a stroke. Remember that I have DVDs, instructional DVDs on how to sculpt and how to buy them and all that at the end of the video. So please, please take a look at that. All right, let's get started with today's video. And I'm sorry I had to take this time, but I figured you might wonder, why is that guy talking so funny? All right, let's get started. Well, my new drink of choice is Sprite Zero. It has no caffeine and no sugar. And it tastes pretty damn good, actually. The reason I'm going to this is because I have to get my blood pressure down, and I'm sure caffeine is a good culprit behind my high blood pressure. All right, let's get started, or back onto my figure here. I'm going to do some changes to it. I'm going to take this hand down. I got too many arms going up, and I think I'd like to put a walking stick in her hand, and I'll bring this hand down and put the walking stick there. I think that'll look kind of cool. I'm going to have to redo that arm, and then I want to work on these rocks a little bit too. And then I got to start cleaning up the figure quite a bit. Well, I had to run to the hardware store because the dowel that I have was right, diameter, but it wasn't the right length because I was trying to work around a stupid... They put labels, the price labels, taped on tightly around the damn dowel, and it ruins a whole section of the dowel, which makes no sense to me. Anyway, I figured the walking stick is going to be about elbow high. In fact, this might be just a little high. I'll just leave it the way it is. I'm not going to put clay on it, and the reason I decided not to put clay on it is because it would be a metal walking stick, and it wouldn't have the imperfections that clay would bring into it. I'm going to bring her hand down and put it right there. I marked how wide her hand is and gave it just a little bit more. And I'm going to make the grip out of clay, or wax, I mean. This is the grip right there. You can see that. The stick itself is one of those that you can tighten up and drop down, and you can lengthen it to the length you want, and then you tighten it up and adjust the length that way. I can't sculpt that. That's just too complicated for this sculpture. So I'm going to just do a pull for her to hold. And actually, I think I might, I'm just going to have her hold it. So I'm going to get started on that right now. First, I've got to move this arm down. Somebody suggested I hang the camera on her neck, but I like it the way it is. I just don't want to do that. All right, let's get busy on that. All right, I'm going to have to cut her thumb off. Cut her fingers off. And get those out of there. Gonna have to redo that strap. Yeah, I could have had the thing hanging off her wrist, but I just too many arms going up. I want to get that changed. Now I need to bring the arm down. Nice thing about a wire framework is that you can change the position of the wire. Now let's see how that looks. See, that might be too long. Because you want your arm and your wrist to be at an angle that's not going to get worn out. And having it too high would put pressure on your wrist. So I'm going to shorten this stick a little bit. Maybe a quarter of an inch or half an inch. That's better. There. And maybe what I'll do, so there's not so much hanging out, is bring it across there like that. Any time that you change an armature's position, like the arm, and you've already worked on the arm, you got to do a lot of adjusting of the clay because it wants to come off the armature now. So you got to be real careful to not have that happen. It also means that parts that weren't showing are showing now. So I've got to adjust that too. The reason I'm putting the stick right next to her leg is to try to cut down on the cost of and the chore of trying to cast that whole stick. The foundry is, you want to keep it friendly for the foundry. So by putting it on her leg, it won't break loose from the base and it won't, over time, get bent. This is, because, you know, you got to think these are going to be around for thousands of years, maybe. And I know it's hard to comprehend, but it's very true that what you create in bronze will outlast the civilization that you're living in. Now you got to find something to... I've got to incorporate this into the leg a little bit. There we go. So there's no light showing between the stick and the leg. All right, I got the walking stick attached. I've got the hand started. I'm going to come back tomorrow. This is really late in the evening. I've got some other things I need to do before I go to bed. And I'm going to continue this tomorrow morning. And it might be a two-parter because I'm going to have to go over this thing with a fine-tooth comb. And I probably won't be showing everything I do tomorrow. It's Saturday. But I want to get this thing done tomorrow so I can photograph it on Sunday and then take it to the foundry, maybe Monday or Tuesday. I got a doctor appointment on Wednesday, and I got a physical therapist appointment on Wednesday as well, so won't be doing any sculpting on Wednesday. And I want to get this to the foundry as quickly as I can, and I got to get some good pictures of it to my friend as quickly as I can too for him and the lady this is being done for or of. So everybody keep healthy, and I will try to do the same. I found out that Bell's palsy, and it may be an old wives' tale, I don't know, but I've heard it from more than one person, that it can be triggered from Lyme disease and from the wind. Just, you know, the wind. And if you do a search on YouTube for Bell's palsy, there's some really good videos. There's one guy who did a simple explanation of Bell's palsy and how it starts, or you know, what you need to do if you do get it and stuff like that. There's about a 72-hour golden period after you notice you have it to get help. And you don't want to delay that help. I did. I worked on this, and I should have probably gone to the hospital right away. But don't waste the moments after you find out you got something like this, or a stroke or anything. There's a certain stroke has got a 1 hour golden period in which you can get, you need to get help, and this has a 72-hour or 3-day period. I hope I was within that, because if I wasn't, going to take a lot longer to get this everything back to normal. But I'm doing everything I can. All right. Good night, everybody. And that's my hiker. I like her arm that way better because everything was too up. Her arms were all up. Everything was up. And I don't like something to look like a fence post. I want it to look like a damn person. All right, everybody, good night, and see you tomorrow, tomorrow.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.